and I think that we should be giving to the nonprofits in this community that actually service this community in this area. And so if you have a nonprofit and things going on, please feel free to share it, because this is Thankful Monday for Giving Tuesday. And so, but Miss Wiley, okay, good girl.
About to put him on. Thank you.
But Miss Wiley, I'm about to handle this real quick. Let me see. Just do that. We can ask you to mute your phone.
Yeah, we right.
Well, I just do that. And so, Miss Wiley.
Good evening. How you doing?
Super fantastic. Enjoying the best day of my life. And so we want to give you the floor today to go ahead and talk about what you have going on and about Goodwill and the programs that you're doing.
Great. Can I share something on the screen?
Okay, get this. Sit down. Let me check this out. I don't have practice. So let me see. Share screen, right?
Mm-hmm. Maybe I can
share the whole thing and then she can share her screen.
Right. Make host. Right here. Here you go, right here. You are good to go. Just change it back when you finish.
Great. Can you all see my screen?
Yes.
Great. Okay. Well, good evening, everybody. I am Raquace Wiley, and I am the program manager of the Ignite Reentry Program. So we have a training program right now where we're funding young adults to be trained in a variety of skills, from highway construction to forklift driving, CDL, welding, some basic logistics training, and things of that nature. It includes, most of the trainings include some type of OSHA, first aid, CPR, and just some other specialized certifications to each industry. And some of the requirements to be a part of the program is that you have to have a criminal background, or you do not have a high school diploma. So for some of the trainings, you have to be at least 18, like so, and have a driver's license if you want to get a CDL. Welding, just 18. So it depends on what field you are, whatever requirements are in that industry, you still have to facilitate those to get the certifications, but we support you in finding the right match for your for training. And we also provide supportive services like MARTA cards, gas cards, or even something like, say, for instance, your car breaks down and you need tires, or things of that nature we've been able to do for some of our young people. We even had a young man who needed to have complete his DUI training class so he can get his license back so he could go to work. The key is to be motivated, reliable, and dependable in the program. So we do what we call an assessment to see if you possess any of those skills at the beginning. If so, it's like a 3-day assessment. If you're there every day, the chances of you not getting in the program will only be so an issue if you do not meet the basic requirements, which is to have a criminal background and or do not have a high school diploma. Most of the slots are for those with a criminal background, and that's not driving violations. That's actually something a little bit more tangible than moving violations. And high school diploma, we have like 15 slots for that. And then we won't have any more slots for that. Right now, I think we have about, we had originally 15. I know for sure we used at least 5. So we have like 10. Any questions about that? The contact information is on the flyer. I'm gonna send it to Ms. Leverett and the councilman so you all can have access. So I tried to download it while we were waiting, but it wouldn't allow me to do it. So Tamika, I'm gonna send it to you, okay?
Oh, don't worry about it. We will definitely get this out. So what you're saying is that you remove the barriers or an excuses of people with an alternative background to not just help them find employment, but also sustain that employment through motor cars and or tires, as you might say, and gas cars.
Yeah.
Well, that's Goodwill. that's a good thing of goodwill.
Yeah. And this is a great program. It's actually through the Department of Labor, and it's through Goodwill International. So we were chosen as one of the six Goodwills in the nation to do this. And it's a lot of money. And I'll be honest with you, the hardest thing we're getting folks to do is do the on-the-job training. People don't want to do the on-the-job training if it's not actually everything that they wanted it to be. And I'm just thinking, we're paying for your training to get these skills. If you can do an OJT and then get employed, that's always great. The funds are for employment. So
that's, thank you. And then is there any subsequent funding in the other resources that when they have employment that they may able to be able to find housing as well? Is that through you guys, or is that another subsequent?
So the program? Housing would not be through us. Our mission is to put people to work. We don't really focus on, but we do have partners that we can connect them with to see if they can get some supportive housing, temporary housing, depending on where they live. We can make some connections.
It's all about connecting, you know? That is awesome. Thank you so much for sharing this. We will be getting this out to the community. How many people, you're one of the six programs. What is the target goal in reaching the number of people?
Say that one more time.
What is the target goal of how many people that you could help with this go around with the funding?
Okay, so the goal is 105. Year to date, we've served 36.
Oh, we got a long way to go. Let's push to the max.
Yep. And we need, September 2022 is the deadline to use all these funds.
We're going to beat that deadline. Absolutely. I have full faith and confidence. And that's actually, helping with the recidivism rate. So I know some Chief Gamma's office because, look into that as well. So that's awesome. Thank you so much.
But I can put you'll get it out, but I can at least put my phone number on the link. So you can reach out to me and I'll put my email address out there too.
Please do. Thank you so much.
But thank you so much for your time.
I have a couple questions for you. And if no one else has a question, I have a couple. So this is specific to your program. And so are the programs for the training just for them, or are they applying to use Goodwill's other training programs and you're just covering for them to get into them?
Yeah, so not all of our training programs are can be used for this. So for instance, a program we have right now called Floor Tech, this program does not qualify because it's not connected with a technical college. So The key is that the trainings that we are supporting have got to give them certifications from the technical schools, which makes total sense if you think about it. There's people appreciate something that has that sort of background, that sort of legitimacy. So so that will be the only program. We have a Tech Bridge that also is not through any technical college, so we don't do that one either. So that's the key. If there's a program that you see listed that does not have a partnership with a technical school, more than likely this grant will not cover it. But with that said, it's really important to come in to what I call our information sessions and our MRD, just to kind of see what the programs are about and what they have in them before you decide you don't want to do them. They're really great. Like I said, you have welding certifications, you have CDL Class A, Class B, connected with logistics or with highway construction. You have flagging certifications, forklift certifications, and then OSHA safety certifications included as well.
So my next question would be, when they have a record, they have to get like bonded and things like that. Is that still something that happens when they have a record, or does they don't really do that anymore?
Well, I think it's still being done. We don't require it. A lot of the employers that we work with don't necessarily require bonding. They tend to take our folks just the way they are based on our reference of them. So right now, we don't do the whole bonding thing so much anymore. But it is important to some employers, but we haven't had any issues with that.
All right. So your program is not only for the training, but you're helping them to actually get jobs once they complete.
Yes.
And I think sometimes people don't realize how much time. How long are these training programs in general ranging?
Anywhere from 2 weeks to 8. Actually, if you get a CDL, it's going to be 11 weeks.
So we had to end it. We had one more month of this year. So they could be truck driving by Valentine's Day before the 1st of March if they were to get in now.
That is correct. We have a class starting in December for CDL highway construction with CDL Class B. And that's in the South DeKalb location. And they're recruiting now. The class, I believe, is supposed to start the second week in December. So that would be next week. They're doing orientations and assessing folks. So it's like a 2 to 3 day assessment. You have to be there to show that you're really serious. And then that's really pretty much it. If you qualify, you qualify.
What do you think is I know you said one of them is them completing the training. Is it because they don't have a way to get to class, personal issues going on, really not being committed in that age group? What do you think? Is it a combination?
I think it's a variety. Everyone is unique. And we try to assess people based on their own situation. You know, because someone could not be able to get there, but they're motivated. They just need a bus pass. Some folks have a car. They need gas money and they'll show up. Or some folks may be on public transportation or live too far out, or could be a childcare concern. All those things factor into success. So we take folks case by case.
So basically, they just need to be willing to come and not come with the excuses before they come, but come with what are their issues and talk to you about them. And so right. Everybody on here today, if they could tell 5 people, 10 people, post it on their own social media or something, that would really help you, I take it.
Oh, yes, it would be great.
And can we ask you to come back another day?
Oh, definitely. That's definitely, as long as it's in the evening.
No, it is. He does this every Monday, but we want to make sure we help you get your numbers. So if we can have...
I really appreciate it.
You know, yes, and we can also get this in our newsletter on Monday, too.
Great.
So if you have a press release, I mean, I can just put this, but if you have a press release, I sent you my email in the chat. If you could send it to me, and we'll put an article in the newsletter.
Okay. I can look into a press release. I'm not allowed to do that. I will have to have our marketing team look at that, and I will bring that up to them.
Okay. We're going to get them numbers. That's what we do want to do. So, you know, that's we do want to market that. Absolutely. Go ahead.
Can we get some of the people to commit that they will pass this info on? Because I really think that we need to. And there's other training programs out there, not just for 18 to 24. That's specifically the one you're over.
That's correct. Yes.
This goes up through all age groups, correct?
Goodwill serves pretty much anybody.
Okay. Does anybody have questions about her program and or anything else about Goodwill programs?
No, I have no questions, but I will be helping to get that information out.
I really appreciate that. Thank you so much.
Tell your church. How many people go to church and somebody is got in trouble? Tell them. Some grandparents taking care of teenagers or taking care of their kids, or some kids still living at home. Tell those people. There is something to get somewhere consistent.
I can't find a job. I got a record. I can't do this. You know what I mean? They just eliminated every barrier of excuses. So I really appreciate that. So we're going to definitely get all of that information out.
And so,
thank you so much.
Thank you.
So, okay, the next, tomorrow is Giving Tuesday. And so, you can share back the host. And tomorrow's Giving Tuesday, and we just want to use this opportunity to have talk about your nonprofit. And we have Mr. Courtney Seals here from Bear Strong. Go ahead and tell us a little bit about your organization, sir, and what you have coming up. Get you back home. Hello?
We might have lost him. We can do him when he comes back.
Ms. Wells, can you turn back to the hosting? Thank you, Ms. Sheila, for being committed to pass along this information.
Okay, who do you need to go next?
Is Mr. Seals on here from Bear Strong?
He was, but I don't see him right now, so we may need to wait for him to get back on. Who do you want to go next?
Who else we have on here with nonprofit?
How do you?
We got it. You already gave it back, Ms. Wiley.
Okay, thank you.
Alrighty, I'll go next while we're waiting for him. Let me see. So, my organization is Facts to Thrive. This is Tamiko Leppert, and so this is our first Giving Tuesday. So we're a little excited. But ours is also a training program, but we have some online and we have some in person. So these classes that you currently see here, financial literacy classes that we're offering, we are in partnership with Fifth Third Bank, and they are literally teaching the class. So I am just helping coordinate to get people to these classes, and they are being taught and speaking directly to the people in the bank. So they have the ability to ask them whatever questions they want. But these are our primary categories that we teach classes on. Financial literacy, technology, which includes our senior tech classes on how to use their cell phone. There are a lot of people who don't know how to work these smartphones. Our health and wellness includes, we have a CPR class that's launching this month at Burdett on December 18th. The career development is where we also partner with different organizations like referring people to Goodwill. We have other organizations for technology classes that we partner with to refer people to them. We have some civics classes. So these are our programs right here. We have a small business plan class coming in January. All of our classes are free except the business plan class and CPR class, because we have to pay for the cards to show they're certified. In our business class, we take the money to help pay for the supplies and the teacher, but we also have written that they'll get some of the money back. And Fifth Third has also sponsored to partner on that business plan class. So we are asking for your help, whether it is a volunteer of your time or whatever it is that you feel like you can do. You can donate funding, you can donate time. We will take whatever you are willing to provide to us, and we will use it. We take suggestions. I just got a call earlier today on how to get to the media. So we are definitely open to knowledge and information and passing it on and receiving it. So keep us in mind for today or tomorrow on Giving Tuesday.
Absolutely. And those are facts that you can thrive upon. I'll tell you so much. So thank you so much, Ms. Leverett. Next, we do have Mr. Seals from Bear Strong. I want to give him the opportunity. Chantel, I see you. Christian, I see you. We'll get that. And Mr. Seal, go ahead, sir.
Hey, everybody. How are you doing? Thank you so much, Mr. Reeves, for having me on. I appreciate you so much. And even though I can't see everybody, I hope you're having a great day and had a great Thanksgiving. This week or next week, December 5th, which is Sunday, my nonprofit organization, Bear Strong Inc., is doing our second annual Kids Are Essential Drive. This drive essentially is to collect donations of essential items for children, socks, underwear, t-shirts, diapers, sweaters, hoodies, coats, baby wipes, deodorant, shampoo, soap, toothpaste, toothbrushes, hairbrushes, combs. We're collecting all essential items for children in need December 5th, 2021 at the Grown Folks Cafe on Old National Highway, starting at 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. I'm very excited about it. I've been getting a lot of support from the community, as well as the cycling community, as well as a few of my celebrity friends. And I just wanted to, I want to thank you, Mr. Reeves, for helping me get to this point and at least having me on so I can tell everybody about it, because we've been pressing hard to get as many volunteers as well as people aware of the event on Sunday. So if you guys are around and available between 10 and 4 and you have something you want to donate, please, we'll be out there in the parking lot from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. collecting donations.
Absolutely, absolutely. Well, Mr. Sarah, thank you. And y'all will know exactly who they are. They want my blue hoodie. You know, I love my blue hoodie. You know, you know Bear Strong, and they do such good work in this community. Partnering with their long-time partners with Old National Merchants Association. And right, and so... that's good today. Still around people. Love y'all efforts and
thank you so much. Thank you again. I appreciate you guys. And you can, if you can, follow me on Instagram. Bear Strong, B-E-A-R Strong, N-P-O, a nonprofit organization at Bear Strong N-P-O. And my personal is Higher. H-I-G-H-E-R, Level, L-E-V-E-L, Bear, B-E-A-R, Higher Level Bear. And thank you so much for the opportunity to speak with you all, and I look forward to seeing you on Sunday, and God is the greatest.
Absolutely, absolutely. It never disappoints. And so we have blankets for my buddies that will be contributing, and so
I can't wait.
They're going to be adding some items. Add items in the chat, too, if you don't mind. We just got that request, and because we have another thing, the Giving Bowl. So we, this is all coordinated efforts, and so to bring this cohort all together.
Okay, let me. Thank you. I'll figure out how to add the items to the chat. I'll figure it out right now. Thank you.
Absolutely, Miss Chantel Goodry, how are you? Jacob's healing hand. Is Chantel with us? Okay, so Chantel.
Hey, Councilman Reeves, before we get Chantel on the phone, I just want to let everybody know that I dropped a document in the chat with links to some of the organizations that Councilman Reeves already works with that's already supporting us in D5. So you can just download that document there, and you can click directly on to the link of some of the nonprofits like Facts to Thrive, Chantel Guidry, who we're waiting on her, Jacob's Healing Hands, and some other organizations we work with.
Absolutely. And so this is where I just have a fundamental belief that if we're going to be giving Tuesday, you know, and let's give to the organizations in the community that are actually helping in this community here. And so I just think that goes a long way. And so I'm going to push that and always push that as I think that, you know, it takes a village, but it also a dream plus funding equals reality. So, you know, we do need funding, and these organizations have a proven track record. And so that being said, let's continue on. Chantel, are you ready for us? She says so high up there, you know, but that's all good. We're going to circle back around. Johnny just jumped on the phone. Johnny Clark, tell us about your program, sir.
All right, he just got his sound. Johnny, you are up to tell us all about you and your organization.
Johnny, here's Johnny. Okay, not ready to talk about.
Has Kristen gone yet?
No.
Councilman Reed, that would be a great class. How to use Zoom. You would be surprised.
I'm trying. Hey, get this. We have that coming up too, by the way. And so, you know, because it's just push. But hey, get this. I had to learn myself. So, you know, I was my first student.
Yeah, but I'm just saying there's a lot of features on here, and that would be an excellent class.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you so much. And so we will be putting that on the list. And so
Kristen, do you want to go?
Kristen says she doesn't want to speak.
Okay. All right, Johnny, can you unmute Alta? We lost Chantel, so while she's trying to get back on, I can talk a little bit about her organization. I know that she provides food for people who don't have food. She supports food insecurities and feeding people who are hungry. I also know she works with people who are seniors that need medical supplies. And she pays for a lot of things out of her pocket. So she definitely would love for people to support her organization and any of her services. Reach out to her.
Her mobile food pantry?
Mm-hmm. All righty. Johnny still can't get off of mute.
Johnny.
All right, do you want to tell him a little bit about what Alta does? Councilman Reeves?
Yeah, Alta is Athletes Learning to Achieve More. And so basically, and just doesn't teach them, and he doesn't coach basketball, also teach life lesson skills, how to change a tire, how to barbecue, just normal things that in absence of male guidance in their life, that he offers those programs along with male guidance as well. And so because dads do have to work and pay the bills. And so it's a great program, just tremendous to see young men change oil for the first time, I tell you. But that's something they never, ever forget, and that's something that they take with them in life. And as long as playing basketball, and I know one of his players actually was a gamer. And in that world, I don't even know about that world, but everybody knew he's a big time gamer. And so, and that's a real career, actually. And so, and I encourage that organization to give. And he just take all the young boys, hard-headed young boys. You got to, you know, sometimes you got to go upside the head, you know, but that's okay. That's for the right reasons. And so, and they're right here in the community, been here a while. And so I just really support this organization because I see the change in the lives of the young men that it actually makes. And so that's something that is we can hang our hat on. Okay. Chantel, are you back with us?
I'm sorry, I am. I was just trying to get out of the office. I'm sorry.
Well, you know, you got to pay the bills. I know, you know, bills are real.
Bills are real. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
Yeah, but no, go ahead. You have the floor. We'll talk about Jacob's Healing Hands. Tamiko did give a little insight about your program, but you can go ahead and tell Monia.
Oh, okay. I'm sorry. Hello. Yes, my name is Chantel Guidry, and I'm the founder of Jacob's Healing Hands. We're a nonprofit organization that assists individuals without health insurance receive home health and medical equipment for free. We also provide personal items for those that wear diapers or depends or bed pads, bed liners, and wipes. So we dress up for free. And our last endeavor that we did, we purchased a school bus and we took the majority of the seats out and we turned it into a mobile food pantry. So we go down to the farmer's market and get the fresh produce and we put on an event or tent event and give the produce out to the community for free. So that's what Jacob's Healing Hands is about. Sorry, I'm puffing and puffing because I'm walking to my car.
It's all right. We know you're getting your steps in. And so, you know what I mean? You're ready to go home and make you some fresh stir fry vegetables. And so that is an awesome organization. As you know, I love veggies and I love growing them. And, you know, and passing that knowledge on down to the subject matter expert, because I'm not a master gardener. But at the same time that we can all know it's growing.
There we go.
And so thank you so much for your organization and all what you do. Indeed, all of these organizations service this area right here, homegrown. So,
Councilman Reeves, I just wanted to let you know I'm finally able to be heard.
Oh, now. Johnny. Yeah, here's Johnny. How you doing, sir? Go, hey, get in. Go right on ahead, sir, and talk to him about Alta. I gave a little bit of insight, but nobody can do it quite like you.
Yeah, yes, sir. I heard you. I thank you very much for that insight.
You have the floor, sir.
Yes. Lost you for a second there. Can you hear me now, Corey?
Yes, sir.
Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay, just to give a little background on my program. We've been in existence now almost 20 years. We actually recently became a nonprofit a few years ago. I was doing it, not thinking about the nonprofit side of things because it was something that I was doing from my heart, something that was done for me. Dad wasn't really there. So I had a lot of men in my life that helped me get to where I am right now. And I thought that this was a way that I knew that I could touch boys by giving them a game that they like. Also in the midst of that, giving them life lessons to help them get along in other matters as well. A few things about the program. We are a travel basketball program. So we travel, we try to get the kids outside of 285 so they can see there's things outside of just. That's one of the things I love because you get a chance to really see them and the surprise and certain things that they see that they don't get a chance to see on an everyday basis. As Corey said, my biggest thing is the life lessons part of it. We're in the midst of basically making sure that we have people that come in. I try to make sure I bring in Black men to give them avenues other than just college, because as we all know, most kids, you know, we want them to go to college, but a lot of kids don't want to go. And a lot of them are not college materials, but that doesn't mean that they can't have a successful life. So the trade pattern is the way that I feel that that's a way that they could actually go. So I have enough friends of mine that are Black men that own their own businesses or working in trades that come and speak to the kids. And we actually had one kid after one life lesson class, he started his own lawn care service right in the subdivision cutting grass. You know, the one thing I try to do with the boys is break things down to them in a simple manner, because we all know the young man with the lawn care service, you know, he looked at, I want to make this amount of money. But you're looking at the big amount of money. As I explained to him, if you do 10 houses a week, that's $400 a week that you basically, if you charge $40 a head, that's $400 a week that you've made. He was just shocked that it was that simple. The breakdown of it was that simple, because they look at the big number and not realize it's the little number that's going to get you to the big number. So we definitely focus on that. I actually have my first young man that's going to be probably going to the NBA after this year. He's down at the University of Miami. So I'm looking forward to that. And we just try to help where we can help, do what we can do.
Absolutely, man. And I just say 20 years of service, man. And, I just want to just say nonprofits are great. They're one of the greatest resources a community can have. But I'm going to be honest with you. It's there to me is a business of the nonprofit. And so I know it's a not-for-profit business, but there's a business side to running a nonprofit. And so these people, they've been doing it out of the kindness of their heart and out of their own pockets and just giving back. But once you do that and you start expanding, well, the need outweighs the financial capacity that one may have. And that's why we just need to kick on in. And on Giving Tuesday, that's one of the best ways to exercise. I'd say thank you for taking your time and your money to put these efforts out. And so, and particularly, see that I just want him to say that entrepreneurship, that trade is it leads to straight entrepreneurship. And so I champion that. And so because college is not for everybody. We all went, but you know, but at the same time, some people just like working with their hands. And so, and there's all kind of trades. Matter of fact, during this last 2 years, there's more businesses that did pop up and happen. And so I love the entrepreneurial spirit. Just never give up, never give in. And so do we have any more on here today? Do we have any more nonprofits want to say anything about your nonprofit or the things that you may not have a nonprofit, but just the things you are doing in the community?
Did Nobody? You speak on what Ms. Mumford is doing?
Ms. Mumford, to those who might not be aware, is one of the greatest. She's just been in the community for a long time. I remember playing old national football. She was
since 1986.
Since 85. And so
85, yeah.
Yeah, and so, you know, and so they've just been a family, a tremendous, when you talk about resolve and when you talk about resiliency and when you talk about how to just press through the storm. I mean, if anybody remember the accident on Royal 85, the three young men that lost their lives, two of them were her sons. And one of her sons is actually a South Fulton firefighter. And she works at Children's and so Hospital. But every holiday, every Thanksgiving, is she feeds all the fire stations. She cooks at her house and, you know, she goes and feeds all the fire stations. And this year, we wanted to honor her in that field. And so, and she's just truly a champion. And so I know we had extra boxes of food. She just made a couple calls and they just came and disappeared. And so she's just that type of person that's all. Never want to glisten and glamour. She just wants to just service her community. And for that, when people do that, I'd like to just go all out for them and just give them their roses right here, because that's just a heart of service. And we have many examples of that, and she is a prime example of that. And I've been going out in so long. And so September the 25th is when they have the visual every year on Roll 85 where the accident did occur. And I'm going to let her lead the effort, but if she wants like a headstone or something like that to kind of commemorate. And fire station number 7 was the first to respond to that call. So she's just an excellent example of resiliency, and just because it's never easy losing a child. I can only imagine. I don't want to imagine, but I don't have kids myself. But I watched my mother go through it. So it's a definite situation. So, but all praise be to God that, you know, show resiliency, and we're able to honor her, and she able to still service and honor our community by feeding the firemen, all fire stations, all of them on Thanksgiving Day. And if any one of y'all wants to go over there and take them a meal, Popeye's meal or something, feel free to drop by and make some spaghetti dinner. I mean, they will be accepting, and just, you know, go get to know the men who would respond to a call in case of an emergency. And they get this, they respond to more non-fire emergencies than anything. So it's also to a good learning experience and a learning tool, actually, all that they do. Okay, anybody else who wanna? You good in the choir? Okay, well, thank you everybody for that nonprofit segment. But I want to talk about,
Oh, I'm sorry. I was going to ask if Officer Garvin was still on here, if she wanted to announce the next coffee with the cop, if she's still here.
She says she lost connection.
Oh, okay.
Right. So, but okay. Now, that's the nonprofit. That's over. Now we can talk to other businesses. Runoff election. How many ready for the Super Bowl tomorrow? Anybody ready for the Super Bowl tomorrow?
I already voted.
Already voted. All right. Anybody
already voted?
Already. That's what I'm talking about. Already. That's what I'm talking about. So we got them on there. Who ain't voted? Who has not voted?
Voted already.
Me, because I like voting election day. That's just how I roll. But I appreciate all y'all early voters, because y'all just let me walk on in and walk out. But I do believe on this, and I will, 7 a.m., I'm right there. And we're going to get the day started, and I'm going to try to make some efforts and roll to the poll. I just want to get the numbers up. I mean, and so you can support who you want to support, but I mean, if less than 1% decides leadership, I mean, I'm just saying, they got to take it how it's given. But I encourage you to call your neighbors, just call anybody, everybody you know that's in the city, and just ask them, have they voted yet, and what time do they intend to go vote tomorrow? And so I think this is an important election. And so, because you have two runoff races, you have actually the mayor's race and District 4. And so, the dynamics can change very quickly and swiftly. So, but it's up to you. It's strictly up to you. If you get up and get out and get a vote, turn up and turn out Tuesday. Triple T. Absolutely. That's what I'm saying. So we want y'all to definitely exercise that. Please exercise that. And for the sake that you just can, you can do it. That's something that you have the absolute power to do. And so it is 7:21. Is there anything else that anybody want to say?
Yes.
Go ahead.
Can you give me the update on, you know, I have Mallory Road out over here and I have Stack Road out. So we are backed up, nowhere to go. Can you give me a little update on that?
Get this. I literally just got an email from
my city manager. I'm working with your visa. The bridge is over CSX Road and the guardrail, not the current bridge rail. Specifications, severe damage. They're gonna send out an estimate along one side of the bridge, and they hope to hear back soon. But we just okay. They're working on opening the bridge to two-way traffic by using the YDOT plastic barriers. So, but get this, we have a Bury the Beauty project that we did, and get this, we have four concrete barriers sitting right over there. Would y'all prefer the plastic or the concrete? I like the concrete.
Are you saying that they are going to put the plastic barriers up and we will be opening up like 2 days from now? We need that.
Their words, not mine. Based on an unknown timeline of the repair work, we are also recommending opening the bridge to two-way traffic by using the YDOCK plastic barriers. They have some attachments and to secure along that side of the bridge that was damaged. So that is going to make a narrower passageway. They're going to need to get some structural engineering because there was a hairline crack that just keeps getting bigger because people was just taking them little cones and moving them out the way and just going on about their business. Probably more damage, actually. But I do think that they need to be opened up ASAP. And so they didn't give me a timeline in this email, but I can guarantee you this is my number one objective. Because with Stash Road being out, this cannot happen. Because now it's almost like you're barricading in. Like it's a one way in, one way out type situation. And that's just not good for anything.
That's right.
So, Mr. Johnson, trust me, I got you. I've been down since 148 that day on what has happened going to Friday after Friday morning after Thanksgiving. So, but we're working on the text alert, so y'all will be able to get that information as soon as I get it like that. And so just don't mind if you get a text at 2 or 3 in the morning, you just might get it because you're going to get it in real time. And so, but we're working on that to have that up and going. And so that everybody be informed. Because like you was today, Ms. Johnson, going down Fairwood and you thought you'd go down Mallory and then had to, I just bet that was just an ordeal. But we're gonna mitigate that real quick.
I hope so.
Oh, get this. Yeah. Real quick. And get this. We got four concrete barriers sitting right over there already. Painted by the Girl Scouts. Hashtag 2382. And so So this is my moving them on over there and let's get this open up. Now the roadway, and we have to put on them narrower, because bridge, it will be a narrow pass through.
Well, it's already narrow, Corey.
Well, and get this, even just even more narrow because those bulky and they bulge out. Because the material for that, that guardrail is sitting at sea. So we just, there's a inventory issue. But hey, get this. We're going to come through it. Like I said, we're just going to handle that. Let's just get that done so that I can get open back up as quickly as possible. And I'm kind of looking at this week too, right? So, well, not kind of, I'm looking at this week. Oh, yes, ma'am. So, we're going to make it happen. And it's going to be the end of the month tomorrow. All right. Does anybody else have anything? Well, ladies and gentlemen, it is Monday night. It is 7:26 p.m. And we're just going to get off a few minutes earlier.
As always, if anybody got fried up some wings, just six of them and pepper. Just save me some right there. Give me some fries. Oh, and oh, by the way, Johnny also do another thing. He fried up some of the best fish this side of Mississippi. So I think we're going to have a contest coming up soon because Ms. Mumford said that she can fry that fish too. And it's just like, I love that. So look for that coming up and just look for more things. And join us again next Monday night. Tell a friend, tell your neighbor. If they say they can't find me, get in touch with me, you can always find me Monday night right here, 6:30, 7:30 on a continuous basis. And thank you all for taking out the time of your day to join this call. And I hope it has been informative. I hope that we have been thankful. Now let's give. And so even if you don't have nothing to give, you can give your voice to tell them thank you for the service that they do in the community. And I appreciate you all. Love you with the love of Jesus, and we will see you later. Enjoy the evening.